adding 3D text into your project is not as difficult as it may seem. So today we're gonna do exactly that inside of After Effects. First thing we're gonna do is create a 2D text layer inside of After Effects. Then we're gonna check this box with the cube icon. This will turn our existing 2D layer into a 3D layer. And you'll immediately notice no difference. Chill out, there's more. So the next step is to open up the dropdown and expand the geometry options. If those properties are grayed out, then click Change Renderer and change your renderer from Classic 3D over to Advanced 3D. This will allow you to extrude your text layer so it can interact with environment lights and 3D materials. After you change the renderer, increase the extrusion depth to your liking. For this example, we're gonna go to 300, then we'll bump up the bevel depth a bit and change the bevel style to angular. Now you have this 3D looking text, and in order to move it around 3D space, we're gonna need to create a camera. So go to Layer, New Camera, and tap OK. Hold down Alt on Windows or Option on Mac, and you will be able to move your text layer around 3D space. If you want to create an animation, open the Transform Properties on the camera layer and tap the stopwatch for point of interest and position. We'll be keeping this movement subtle, but you can do whatever you want because you're an adult. Probably. Now set your start and end frames, then add an ease in and out if you'd like. And if you want to dial that ease in even further, click the keyframe, then tap the graph icon to open up your graph editor. In here, you can refine and adjust the speed of your ease. Once you have something you're happy with, you can leave this as is or take it a step further and add some lighting. To do this, go to Layer, New, and tap Light. You have different options here, but for now we're gonna stick with Spotlight. Once you put your lights in, it can be hard to understand where your light is positioned from this view. So we'll go to the right-hand corner of the composition panel and click this dropdown. In here, we can change our view to get a better understanding of where our light is placed in 3D space. So if we click to get a top view, you'll see that our light is directly in front of our text. You can also click the dropdown in the corner and expand your amount of camera views to see from multiple angles. Now we can continue adding lights, changing their color, and even keyframe different properties to create a reveal type animation. Another option is using the built-in presets from Adobe. To find these, go to your Effects and Presets window, open Animation Presets, tap Text, 3D Text, and you'll find a collection of presets that you can drop on your text layer. Now to add in a background, it's often useful to drop in the image, then right-click and create a pre-comp. That way, you have the flexibility to quickly swap out the texture later without affecting any of your settings inside the main comp. You can also just keep the background in 2D space. However, the existing lights won't be able to interact with that. So to fix this, we're gonna make the layer 3D, push that back into Z space, and adjust the scale. Now we have this background that is interacting with the lights we've created. But there you have it. Those are the basics of creating 3D text inside of After Effects. And as always, if you have something you would like to see us cover in the future, feel free to drop us a comment below. And don't forget to like and subscribe because octopi have three hearts, with one stopping when they swim.